Towards the end of 1963, another African nation joins the world organization, Zanzibar. The Prime Minister, Mr. Mohamed Shamte, addresses the assembly on December the 16th, making the point that there is no country so small and so modest in its means that it cannot be represented inside the United Nations on equal terms with the great states of the world.
Mr. President, it is a very great honor and a very great pleasure for me to be here as Zanzibar's representative at the moment when Zanzibar's application to join the United Nations organization has been accepted by the General Assembly. Zanzibar's entry to this great organization is, to my mind, of special significance, and this is that there is no country so small and so modest in its means that it cannot be represented here on equal terms with the great nations of the world. There are some people who consider this scheme of things to be wrong, but I consider it to be a source of strength to this organization and one that will inspire Zanzibar to use its privileges with a sense of responsibility and dedication to the ideals which prompted the establishment of the United Nations. To our many friends throughout the world who have done so much in supporting our struggle towards national liberation, to the Decolonization Committee, which has contributed so much in speeding up our march towards independence, and to this august organization of United Nations, to which we owe so much, I would like to convey my country's deep gratitude. To them, we shall continue to look for aid and support in the upliftment of our people, so that we also may be able to contribute our humble share towards the solution of world problems. To the distinguished delegates in the Security Council and in this General Assembly who pay tribute to the struggle and achievement of my country, I would like to convey the sincere gratitude of my delegation. To all those who have sponsored our application and to all the distinguished delegates who have unanimously voted us into membership of the United Nations, I say thank you. Mr. President, political problems tend to hit the world headlines, but it is not generally known, for instance, that malaria, which a few years ago used to cause as much havoc as any war, is now almost wiped out from Zanzibar as a result of an intensive joint effort on the part of WHO, UNICEF, and the government and people of Zanzibar. It is also not known that quietly but determinedly we are trying with the aid of the ILO and FAO to do away with the curse of underemployment. There are many other ways in which individual countries and international organizations have been cooperating with us in solving our problems. We are grateful to them all. Now that the energies of our people are unleashed by the restoration of our national pride and sovereignty, we can look forward with confidence to greater and more comprehensive assistance from every quarter. Zanzibar is one of the smallest nations in terms of population and size, to have been accepted for membership. This in itself entails sacrifices for Zanzibar, sacrifices which are of little significance to nations of great wealth, but are of very great concern to us, of slender means. These sacrifices we are very glad to make. If we are not rich in numbers, in territory, in material wealth, we do not account ourselves poor in the values of life, which are so inestimably more important. And it is because of this that we feel we can contribute, even if only modestly, in the affairs of this assembly. We have a long and honorable history and civilization behind us. Like so many of the great peoples of the world, our roots are sprung from many different sources, from Africa primarily, but also from Arabia, from the civilization of ancient Persia, from India, and from many others. The Europeans, in their great voyages of exploration, found succor and sustenance on our shores, and men of many races found rest and stability in our islands, from where to organize the exploration and development of Central and Eastern Africa. It is due to these roots established over the centuries, the mixing of so many cultures, that makes us proud of our reputation for moderation and friendliness. While in the modern world we do not intend to keep looking back towards our past, it is this tradition on which we intend to build for the future. Zanzibar is a constitutional monarchy founded on liberal and democratic traditions, governed by a prime minister and a cabinet of elected ministers with collective responsibility and answerable to a national assembly elected on the basis of universal adult suffrage. The fundamental human rights to personal liberty and protection against discrimination are entrenched in Zanzibar's constitution. Our overall aims are peace and progress at home and abroad. The chief objects must be to help to create a political atmosphere in the world in which men's real enemies of hunger, ignorance, and disease can receive full attention, so that resources and time are not wasted on fruitless matters of dissension. Zanzibar's general policy is one of benevolent and positive neutrality, without discrimination against any country on grounds of race, creed, culture, or ideology. And it supports all measures for peace and progress in the world, and on the basis of international cooperation. On the achievement of its independence, Zanzibar has freely elected to remain a member of the Commonwealth of Nations. And it is fitting and pleasurable to pay tribute to the continuing harmonious relations which have obtained between Zanzibar and the United Kingdom. We believe in the Commonwealth as a large number of equal sovereign states of many people and cultures who have voluntarily and democratically joined together and are dedicated to the furtherance of peace, cooperation, and prosperity throughout the world. It is the object of Zanzibar to strengthen the many ties it possesses with both Africa and the East, and to this end we subscribe to the principles of the Bandung Declaration of 1955 and of the Charter of the Organization of African Unity framed at Addis Ababa this year. Zanzibar has particularly close relationship with the other territories of East Africa, and it is our intention to continue this in friendship and cooperation, whether inside or out of a form of an East African Federation. On this respect, I am particularly glad that Kenya, with which Zanzibar has so many close connections, is being welcomed into this assembly at the same time. At this proud moment in our history, I may be permitted to quote Shakespeare and say, "We are two lions littered in one day." Sir, in submitting the application for membership for Zanzibar, I have made a solemn declaration in common with that made by other nations represented here today, that on behalf of my government, I have accepted the obligations contained in the Charter of the United Nations and undertaken to fulfill them. This solemn declaration is a very real one for me, and I pray with the assurance that this will indeed be so, that Zanzibar in future years will honor it to the full. Thank you, sir.
Ya manani uepushe kila shari, twakuomba ya manani tuepushe kila shari, utupe nyingi imani na kila jema la kheri, utupe nyingi imani na kila jema la kheri, tupendane visiwani sote tulo Zanzibari, tupendane visiwani sote tulo Zanzibari. Mola wetu imani na umuri visiwani, ziondoke zetu dhiki ziondoke zetu dhiki. Sote tutanemeka, uondoke ufakiri, tusahau yalotoweka, katutusia fikiri, tusahau yalotoweka, katutusia fikiri. Ondoke zetu dhiki.